You ready?
I'm ready.
And here we go. What up? Welcome back to another video, guys. It is a very, very cold day out here in dirty Jersey. We're gearing up. We're about to head out to Garden State Harley Davidson to do a review video. And we're also going to be picking up a new bike for my cousin. He's coming in. He's on his way over here. So, yeah. And he might be leaving it in my garage, too. So, it might be like a project bike. So, that's also a plus for you guys, for me, and yeah. All right. So, two things we want to talk about today. Obviously, as the news is coming out, we're 2 days away from the big delivery, all the new information that we're gonna be receiving from Harley Davidson, as far as new paint jobs, any new bike reveals, and any new changes that they've done to any of the Touring models or even any of the Softail bikes that haven't been released yet, because there's a few that have been not reached the dealerships yet, and we have some insight and some ideas on what they might be doing, but we might be touching base on that later on in the video. Two main topics we wanted to talk about today is obviously Harley Davidson going from the hydraulic clutch down to cable clutches on the baggers, and then the ECM, right? So I guess we could just hop into the clutch real quick. As far as them doing changes and why they're doing this, I mean, Jerry brought up a good point. I think it's just as far as what, to save money.
I think it's cost cutting. Even though they raised prices, which sucked. I mean, if they took away the clutch and they left the price the same, then you could say, okay, well, instead of raising prices, they did this, but they raised the prices and took away the clutch. But they also had issues with the clutch from a Rushmore thing from 2014 to 2020. Right. They had a lot of recalls on it, so it cost them a lot of money with warranties.
Yeah, so I mean, I've been on the latest models of baggers in the last few years. And I honestly prefer cable clutches as opposed to hydraulic clutches. You prefer hydraulic, right?
It depends on which bike I'm on. On the dresser, I kind of like it.
I don't know.
Road King has a cable clutch. My V-Rod has a nice hydraulic clutch, but that's a different hydraulic
clutch. That's way different, yeah.
Yeah, way different hydraulic clutch. And then the Night Train has a cable clutch. So it all depends on what I'm on.
Yeah, I prefer cable. And on one end, they're saving money. And then on another end is also very cost effective on your end, on the rider's end, because less maintenance and something less you got to worry about, which I think is a plus. I mean, some people are upset about the fact that they're going backwards.
I'm not upset about the fact they're going backwards. I'm upset when they cut costs,
but they don't take money.
Like the key fob bullshit they did last year. Oh, let's take away a key fob. Supposedly now you're getting two key fobs back against because so many people complained.
I mean, yeah. I mean, why would you only give one key fob?
Well, because they said people throw the other one in the drawer. But if you have a spare set of keys and you lose your other keys, still need a spare set with
exactly.
The fob.
If you lose one,
I mean, you
only
can put
one.
The code in manually, but that's a pain in the ass.
Yeah, exactly. Nah, fuck that. So forget, fuck that together. Ah, forget that. All right, and then obviously the most important thing that they are changing for this year, which a lot of people are going to be pissed off about, is the ECMs, which I'll let Jerry explain a little bit more about that.
Well, your ECM, your electronic control module for the bike, is basically like a lot of people were doing aftermarket tuners. And once you plug an aftermarket tuner into your ECM, you void your warranty through Harley Davidson. And it show, even if the dealer did it and then took it off, it still shows it was hooked up in the brain. So they changed the ECM altogether so nobody could hook up any tuners or anything now. And I know what everybody's going to say, well, the aftermarket's going to, you know, they'll just put a different plug. It's not going to be a different plug. You're going to have to get one. Somebody's going to have to get one.
They're going to have to buy a bike, engineer it, and figure everything out.
Yeah.
With that being said, what I do want to point out, because a lot of times I do get a lot of questions of people asking me, oh, well, if I change my exhaust out, would I void my warranty? No. Would I change certain parts out? No. The only thing that's gonna void your warranty is you putting in an aftermarket tuner. Yeah, so if you stay with Harley Davidson and you use the Screaming Eagle, I use the Screaming Eagle tuner on my 2020 Lowrider S. It works fine. I'm happy with the performance. On the dyno, I'm probably gonna use something different. I might go with a dyno jet just because it's just that bike is just my project bike right now, and I'm doing whatever. This one I'm trying to stay like a safer route just in case of anything. And it's a newer model as well. It's still basically brand new. But you really, with that being said, even with the new 2021 models coming out, mm-hmm. no, you won't be able to buy aftermarket tuners until someone, one of those companies buys it and they're able to work around it. That does not mean that you're not able to, you know, add an exhaust or put in a cam or whatever it is. Well, you could, well, it depends, because it gets very tricky with the cam.
Plus the tuner, it's not going to be like you can't have a tuner at all, because Screaming Eagle is going to have a tuner. So you're going to be able to do a Screaming Eagle tuner right from the get-go.
Yeah.
And you're going to be able to do all your performance stuff. And like he was saying about the exhaust, this and that, it doesn't void your warranty, but you have to watch, because some dealers, if they don't install the pipe or they don't install, especially the cam, but other things, if they the air cleaner, like certain things, they will void your warranty just because they won't honor it. Doesn't mean Harley-Davidson won't honor it or another dealer won't honor it, but some dealers are kind of jerks like that.
It's a very shitty thing for them to do at times.
But they do it.
Yeah, they do it. I mean, me, I installed my pipe myself. Pretty sure some of you guys saw that install. I don't have any issues. And I know a ton of people as well that have gotten, they do their own work and they never got any issues. But, you know, you will come across
an occasional dealer
that might give you a hard time about it. And I always tell people, go to your local dealership first, ask questions first. Ask, hey, by the way, I'm about to do certain type of works on my bike. Am I going to have any issues with, you know, A, B, C, and D? And, you know, get that affirmed first and clarify that before you go ahead and do anything. And then go ahead. If they're not going to give you any issues, then go ahead. And if they do give you issues, go to the next dealership, because they all work differently. Mm-hmm. They're all owned independently.
Yeah.
That's, you know, a lot of people think that, you know, it's just one main boss and they own dealerships. No. Each dealership is owned independently, you know? So Jared could have a dealership down the road. I could have one up here, and we completely different owners, and he could be doing things differently from what I do in my dealership. That's the way it really worked.
Yeah, I mean, it's all about, like I said, they're changing this stuff out because the reason they did it, and it's a justifiable reason. If I was Harley Davidson, I'd understand it too. I understand people want to squeeze out all the performance and then get a better tuner, aftermarket, everything. But what was happening is people were going to shops or dealers or other places, and they were getting these tuners put in with the performance work. And then they turned around and they had an issue, and then they went back and they said, well, that's not covered. And they're like, well, I didn't know, because some people set up right up front, it's going to void your warranty. Other people just put it in, didn't tell the people, the customer, it's going to void your warranty.
Right.
Because maybe if you told them it was going to void their warranty, they would have went with a Screaming Eagle or something that was under warranty. Some people don't give a crap about warranty, and some people do. Mm-hmm. I haven't used my warranty, but I have extended warranty because I did all the engine work, stage four and everything. I use a Screaming Eagle tuner. But I haven't used my warranty till this year, 3 years after owning the bike.
You have a Screaming Eagle tuner on your Street Glide, right?
Street Glide, yes.
Okay. Are you happy with the performance? As far as tuner-wise and everything?
Pretty much.
I mean, it's a lot of people talk shit about it. Whatever, but it's a good tuner. Like, it does the job.
My bike rocks. I mean, yeah, can I squeeze some more horsepower? Probably. If I change the cam, I could probably squeeze some more horsepower.
I think if you're going to take your bike to the track, and if you're going to be on one of these bagger races, then go with an aftermarket tuner, because they're just going to tune the bike differently. It's going to run, obviously, everything's going to change drastically, but for the normal person who's just going to be riding, Screaming Eagle tuner is perfectly fine, man.
I mean, I have 120 plus horsepower. I didn't dyno it, but it's somewhere in the 120 plus area, and my bike's very streetable. He rode it, I rode it. Like, it's very streetable. It's not like you're like driving some kind of race car on the street.
Is that a word?
Well, yeah, it's streetable. Like, if you had a race car and you were driving,
it's streetable. I've never heard that shit in my life. Streetable.
If you look up car stop, they say it's streetable. Because some people used to drive race cars.
I like it. I like the word.
They would drive race cars on the road that were race cars. Yeah. They weren't. Yeah, the parachutes, the wheelie bars. Yeah. That's not a streetable car.
Right.
You know, a streetable car is a race car that's semi. It's not street legal. It's semi, that's streetable. Semi street legal. Might not be 100% street legal, but at least you're not going to get pulled over for having a wheelie bar and a parachute on your fucking car. True.
Drop your thoughts down below. Let us know what you guys think about the few little changes. Not drastic. Tuesday, if you have not yet gone on to HarleyDavidson.com, go ahead and confirm and register for the viewing. It's going to be for the public. It's going to be for all dealerships. First time they're doing this. That's going to be this Tuesday. Real easy. It's just basic information, your name, email, and boom, you're done. And then we also got to do a follow-up video from what we did from what we were expecting, the bikes that were going to be canceled.
Yeah, 2021 expert. 2021. expectations.
Now, we were wrong and we were right about some things. So we're going to be touching base on that. That's going to be coming probably at the end of this week.
Well, we were wrong about one bike going away and it stayed. And the bike we thought was going to stay went away.
Yeah, exactly. So we got that one wrong. But everything else, I think we're
pretty much
everything
wrong,
right on the nail. Drop your thoughts down below. We're going to be done here. We're about to head out to Garden State Harley. So you're going to be seeing a few more videos now. So tune in. I'm with the coolest white guy I know, Jerry. And we're going to keep enjoying this cold day out here in dirty Jersey. Like always, guys, thank you so much for watching. Let the force be with you. Ride safe.
Enjoy the ride.
And enjoy the ride, baby. Peace. That was a cool